GearNetwork.com.
The following is a presentation of the Gear Radio Network.
Rich, I'm wealthy, I'm JC Money.
Coming to you live from the Gear Network studios in Rochester, New York, this is the JC Money Show with your host, John Cimino, a.k.a. JC Money. And now, here's John.
Happy 2022, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this edition of the JC Money Show here on the Gear Radio Network. How in the bloody blue hell are all of you? My name is John Cimino at I Am JC Money, and I thank you for tuning in. I thank you for your continued patronage. And you ask, well, wait, what are you selling? I'm selling podcasts, baby. Except you don't have to buy them. You just got to subscribe to them. That's all you have to do. And thank you to those that already did click subscribe and are receiving this without having to have me social media blast you. Because social media, holy shit. I'm so sick of it.
Yes,
I am sick of social media. And maybe I'll talk about that in a small little commentary piece. But this was... Oh, yeah. Thanks for subscribing. That's how you support us. When you click the subscribe button, you get the download. Download goes right to your phone. That helps us. Very, very easy. Very easy to do. Cost you nothing to listen to my nothing or nonsense or whatever. I don't know. Doesn't. Whatever. Who cares? How's it going? Happy 2022, everybody. I'm not saying Happy New Year now. It's January 31st as of press recording. So the Happy New Year thing has passed. But Happy 2022 because there has not been a JC Money show since then. Or since the end of last year. But I got to get the content out. So there are more prank calls that I'm going to release. I'm going to make a conscious effort to get out there a little more with wrestling shows. But it's been tough, man, with Uncle COVID and all this crap going on now with, you know, Cousin Omicron and all that. Like, it's been tough. I've been a hobbit in my house or in the Gear Network studio. I haven't done much. I haven't gone out much at all. And I don't want to until everybody just kind of calms their tits a bit about just everything. And I sit here now as we approach the beginning of year three of this pandemic and all of the different things that are going on in terms of the variants and you know, wearing the masks. And of course, you still got those fucking idiots that will continue to say, you know, they're not wearing masks and infringes on the freedoms and all that stuff. And then you've got the other side that shames people about wearing masks and whatever. You know what? I've been sitting in my basement long enough and in my house long enough during this entire stretch to comfortably say, you do you. All right? That's it. You do you. So many of my people have had the virus now. So many people that I know have had to have the quarantine period going on. My daughters had to be quarantined. I quarantined myself based on their being quarantined and having to test every day to go to school. It's crazy. It's craziness. And I'm over it. I understand the severity of the disease, and I understand the severity of everything that's going on, but I'm over it. I really am. I'm over the fighting. I'm over the bickering. And it's all on social media. That's the worst part about it all, is that it's on social media. It does not seem to me that anybody gives a shit anymore. It's been going on for too long. People have stopped caring. You still have full, you have full NFL stadiums again. You have full venues for wrestling events. You have full venues for UFC fights, NBA games, sporting events, concerts. Like, you have these things now. At this point, I would like to think, and I don't, and I can't back this up by data, I'm just shooting straight from the hip now. But at this point of the game, there's enough masks out there. There's enough vaccines out there. There's enough hand sanitizer out there. In some areas of the country, there's probably not enough toilet paper still because people are still buying that for some stupid reason, buying it up like it's going on to stuff. I'm looking at you, my friends in the South. But there's so many things in sharp comparison to where we were, you know, 2 years ago at this time, almost 3 years ago at this time. No, not really. Almost 3 years ago. I'm sorry. We're completing the second full year, beginning the third year. But there's been 2 years worth of data, worth of science, worth of advancements, vaccines, mass production for masks. They're even sending fucking COVID tests home now. So there's all this awareness. There's all this stuff on here now. Like, I think we're at the point where people can kind of just pick and choose what they're going to do and how they're going to do it. You're going to know the risks. And, you know, you can determine whether or not it's worth taking those risks. There are some instances where I'm perfectly fine going out somewhere. And I know I'm fully vaccinated and boosted and all that shit. If I get it, I get it. At least I know that my chances of being on a ventilator are thin. There's science and data to back it up. I have people, I have friends that are in the exact same boat as me, fully vaxxed and boosted, got COVID anyways, were good after 5 days. Brandon admitted on Listen In, when we did a Listen In podcast a few weeks back. Talked about his COVID process. Talked about what he was still kind of struggling with. But, you know, comparatively speaking, had he not been vaccinated, you know, who knows? Who knows what would have happened to him? But the data's there. The science is there. The numbers are there, should you so choose to look at it. I think we're at the point now where everybody's just got to kind of just take a chill pill. And just, you know, everybody wants to get back to their lives. Get back to your lives. You know, I can't. I'm personally to a point where I don't care if you're vaxxed or you're not vaxxed. I care about me. I care about my clan. And I care about what we do. And I use this to dictate what segments or sections of the world, the public world, that I want to go to based on my trust and knowledge and what I see, what I observe. If I'm in a 7-Eleven and it's crowded, yeah, I'm probably going to wear a mask, especially when numbers are spiking high, with or without a mandate. If it's a quick stop in somewhere, then, and I know I'm the only person in there, I don't freaking need a mask, and I shouldn't be shamed to do it. And I was a mask shamer. I was a mask shamer in the very beginning because I didn't know any better. But the numbers are out. Now I know better. It's called learning. Which some people don't want to do still. And that ties over back into social media and why I'm so goddamn sick of it now. I try my best to stay off of it all week. During big events, during the weekend or whatever, yeah, I'll fart around on it, sure. But during the week, I got other shit to do. But either way, this wasn't a soapbox about, although it became one, a soapbox about, you know, COVID and life as it is now. It's just crazy to me. But I will say, over the course of these 2 years, the amount of time I've been able to sit and reflect and think and do things, it wasn't necessarily the worst thing in the world for me. I made a lot of peace with a lot of people. And we've talked about it before. on this podcast. You know, me being back involved with UPW here in Rochester, not a big surprise anymore. It's been just about a year since I've been back in the fold with that company. Periodic visits, wrestling for them, you know, making plans, things like that. You know, that's not a surprise anymore. I even made peace with Rob Schultz, another one of the people that I had a big issue with for really childish and stupid reasons back in 2005, I think it was, 2004 or 2005, I don't remember. That's how long ago it was. And holding on to those things, like, it was meaningless. It was meaningless. And I saw Rob Schultz at the premiere for the Brody Lee documentary. And I approached him and I apologized to him for my part on it. I didn't ask for an apology from him. I didn't want one because I knew how I treated the man, and it's not indicative of who I am now. But, you know, again, that's a growing thing. That's a growing period. That's personal growth. Acknowledging your faults and, you know, owning up to them. It's not a bad thing, and it's not a terrible thing to say that you're sorry, especially when you were wrong. There's a lot of situations I was correct in, but there was just as many, if not more, that I was incorrect in. And my stubborn ways didn't really see that and didn't look at me as the problem. So I guess I'm going to close this little commentary out here before I get to another prank call. I'm going to close this out by saying, don't be afraid to look in the mirror and give yourself the constructive criticism or honest feedback that you would be very willing to give others. It's eye-opening. I did that for me. And I can tell you, my life is infinitely better now than it ever was. Not just finances or things like that, just personally. When you can look at yourself and acknowledge that you are the cause of and solution to most of your own problems, you can really truly grasp the concept of taking back control of your life and molding it the way you want to and going in the direction that you always knew you could. That's my piece of advice for you. Look in the mirror. And it is okay to be wrong. What's not okay is not learning from it. I am very appreciative of anybody that has given me a second chance, third chance, fourth chance. And now I use my time to coach and help other people that have shared the similar, you know, internal struggles or had very similar stories to me where, you know, you were raised a certain way and that's just the way it was until it's not anymore. And I feel that if everybody can do that and really deep dive and evaluate themselves and work really, really work, put in that work to make yourself better, then I think our overall quality of life as human beings is going to improve. But that's my soapbox. That's my soapbox commentary for now. I'm going to say and end it at that, kick it off to a commercial break. When we come back, I'm going to load up a couple of prank calls for you. I don't know which ones they are because I've been recording them and just storing them. So I'm just going to go through, find the best one that I can during the commercial break, or find a couple one that make me laugh and throw them on there. If they make you laugh, great. If not, tune in next time. Maybe that one will make you laugh. But this, my babies, is the JC Money Show. right here on the Gear Radio Network. Stick around, we'll be right back.
It's Saturday, I see the golden sun is shining up above. Put your blues away.
Welcome back to the JC Money Show. And now, once again, here's John.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for sitting through the commercials. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for everything. Everything. John Cimino, a.k.a. JC Money here. And while I was on commercial break, I went up to go grab something to drink, right? A little coffee, because that's cold down here in the studio, and I cannot, because I freaking hate old man winter. I cannot get warm. And I left my phone downstairs, and sure enough, I got this little bad boy on my voicemail.
Transaction. You then immediately call Amazon Billing and Fraud Prevention Department on the toll-free number, which is 866-879-4187. Again, the number is 866-879-4187.
Okay, so I'm going to assume that this number is probably not active, but I'm going to give it a try right now live on air. And worst case scenario, if this one shits the bed, I'll just send you to another prank call, one of the many in my inventory here. But here we go. 866-879-4817. Let's hit these guys up here. Yep, we're going to call them. Go ahead.
Thank you for reaching Amazon support. How may I help you?
Yes, hi. I got this message on my answering machine saying to call this number about my Amazon account. I don't know what is going on. I don't even know the Amazon.
Okay, so ma'am, I do believe that you receive a voice call from Amazon, right?
Yes, and it gave me this very number, this
yeah,
to call and speak to somebody. Okay, I'm very nervous right now.
Okay,
am I in trouble?
Don't worry about it, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
You don't need to worry, ma'am. We are here for the need. Whew. You don't need to worry about anything.
Okay.
We'll totally help you.
Thank you.
Get rid of that problem, okay?
Thank you so very much.
Can you confirm me first, ma'am?
Yes.
Can you confirm me first, ma'am? Are you the right owner of this number? It's a 5857.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, so ma'am.
That's the number I called to get you.
Okay?
That's the number I called to get you.
Okay. Yeah, there's an order and order which is activated on your Amazon account. So, ma'am, do you have Amazon account or do you deal with Amazon?
I don't even know what that is. Is that what is Amazon?
Yeah, in that case, ma'am, it seems like some hackers on Baltimore, Maryland, might have created a fraudulent Amazon account. It's a,
what is? I have a regular telephone.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, man, do you have a phone with you right now?
Young man, you need to speak a little louder. I have a hard time hearing. Or can I put you on the phone with my husband?
Okay.
Can you? He hears better than me.
Listen to me, okay?
Can you
listen?
Yes.
Okay, listen to me totally, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so ma'am, in that case, ma'am, hacker having a system of your credential information, ma'am, and they are misusing your credential information by create a fraudulent Amazon account. It's an Amazon shopping application.
What is an application? What is an application? Applying application to what?
It's a shopping website.
It's a website.
Shopping website.
Is that like the internet?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, like the internet.
Oh, okay.
So do you have a cell phone, ma'am?
I know what the internet is, but I don't use it very often.
Oh my gosh. Okay, so ma'am, do you have a cell phone with you right now?
What?
Like internet access device?
I have a computer. I have a computer. Yes.
Yeah, so that now, we will help you to remove that hacker from your credential by provide you a cancellation ID.
Okay.
Once you get the cancellation ID, ma'am.
Yes.
Our robot team will help you to cancel this fraudulent order, so we can refund you the amount securely. Okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So ma'am.
Yes.
What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna help you to provide a cancellation ID first. So ma'am, if it's possible, go and sit in front of your computer.
Yes. Oh, okay. I'll need to walk over to it. Is that okay?
Okay, ma'am. Take it then.
Okay. Thank you so much. Okay, I'm there right now.
Yeah, open up your computer. Oh. And ma'am, just do let me know.
Okay.
In your computer.
Yes.
Which browser use?
What?
Which browser, ma'am? Which browser do you use in your computer?
Okay.
Like Google Chrome.
Okay.
Firefox.
Sir.
Microsoft Edge.
Sir, I'm 75 years old, and I don't understand what you young folks, are talking about with the computer. Are you talking about the internet?
Yeah.
My son told me to click on this thing right here with the globe, and that will bring me to, the internet.
Okay.
Yes, so, and
ma'am,
that's what I did.
I
clicked on the globe.
Yeah, ma'am.
And it says Netscape Navigator underneath it.
Okay, ma'am. I do believe that you know how to use your computer, right?
Well, I only use it a little bit here and there. My husband uses it all the time.
Yeah, just do let me know, ma'am. Yeah, just do let me know. Do you know how to use your computer?
I know a little bit of
it.
I just told you I know a little bit.
Okay.
But my husband...
Can...
Sir...
Yeah, we are here for your needs, ma'am.
Okay, but sir, you're not listening to my needs and I'm very nervous. Can I give you to my husband? He's better with the computer than I am. He knows what buttons to click and press.
Okay. You can call him.
I will get him right now. Hold on 1 second, please. Hey, James!
Can you give me one?
James, can you come to the phone? There's a young man that wants to help us with the Amazon. I don't know what that is. But can you help us? Yes, I will tell him to hold on. He's gonna... My husband says hold on. He's in the bathroom right now. He's gonna come down. He's almost done, though. Where do you need me to start with him? I get him... Oh, he's on his way. Hold on. James! James, come here! Come here, you... He's on the phone right now. I don't know. He's telling me to press the buttons and the things. I don't know the computer. Where's little Jimmy when you need him? Jesus Christ.
Hold on.
Hello? Oh.
Yeah, hello, sir. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. Who am I talking to?
Yeah, this is James from Amazon Cancellation Department.
What is your name?
As I can see, sir. Yeah, James. It's a J-A-M-E-S.
Yes, that's my name too. I'm James Springer. Nice to meet you. What can I help you with?
Oh my God, nice to meet you.
What can I help you with?
Sir, so we are here for your needs.
Okay. For my needs? Great. Because what I need right now is a refill on my medicine, but these assholes at Walgreens won't talk to me. They say I'm too loud.
Yeah, sir, we are here for your needs.
Okay, so can I get my prescription refilled for the hymns? Okay. Hurry up.
Okay?
Hurry up.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, so, as I can see, sir, we are here for your need. As I can see, hackers are having a system of your credential information. By creating a fraudulent Amazon account under your personal information, sir.
That who did this?
And
Walgreens?
Without your so we are here to provide you a cancellation ID to remove that hackers from your credential.
What?
So, ma'am. Sit in front of your computer.
Yes.
And just do let me know.
Yeah, I'm in front of the computer. You was talking to my wife, and she said something about the computer.
Yeah.
What do you? I'm here. I'm in front of the computer.
It's not about computer. It's about an iPhone.
What about an iPhone? What is that?
Yeah, hackers made purchase from Amazon.
Hack?
By using your credential information. Yeah.
Give me one second, sir. Dorothy, what the hell are you talking about? This isn't Walgreens. What is this? Who is this am I talking to? Do you wanna just talk to my wife? I think she might know this a little better than I do. I don't know who the hell you are. You're not Walgreens. I need my medication refilled. Hold on a minute. Dorothy, get your ass over here and talk to this guy because I can't understand what he's saying here. What does he want? He wants something with the
why did you take the phone from me then?
I don't know the
computer. I could have talked to him and been on the phone by now, but I can't do that because you're over here acting like an asshole. Jesus Christ! I'll get on the phone with him, but I want you out of the goddamn house! Dumb prick! Jesus Christ!
Hello, sir, and man.
Hello, hi.
Why are you fighting?
What? He's just very rude. He's very rude and nasty to me. We've been married. I know you're trying to help. We've been married for 45 years. And he used to be so sweet and bring me flowers and things. Now he's just a slob and a bum and he doesn't help out with anything.
Okay, ma'am. I do believe that. You can't do it. So we are here for your need.
All right.
We have to.
Okay.
That tackles from your Christmas.
All right, sweetheart. Thank you. What do I need? What do I do? I press the button with the globe. That says Netscape Navigator, and now it tells me to put in my address.
Yeah, ma'am. So, do you have a cell phone with you right now?
I don't have a cell phone, no. My son wants to get me one, but I don't want one.
Okay, ma'am. So, in your computer, ma'am, do you know in which browser do you use in your computer?
It says Netscape Navigator.
Netscape Navigator, right?
Yes. I got this computer back in 1997, and I don't use the damn thing. It just sits here.
Okay, so do you use your internet in your computer? Do you use internet in your computer?
Every now and then I do, but not all the time.
Okay, ma'am. Just hold on, okay?
Yes,
just
please. Please.
This is going much better than I thought it was going to go. I'm going to hit a commercial break right now. We'll come back with perhaps the epic conclusion of this very call here on the Jason Money Show.
Yes, I'm still here.
Hello?
Hi.
Yeah, so ma'am?
Yes.
Yeah, can you let me know which browser is that?
I don't know what you're talking about.
In your computer, ma'am?
Yes. Hold on while I look. Hold on, please. Thank you.
Okay.
It looks like it's something called Jujo Chrome?
Yeah, you need to open that.
Okay, I have that open. Now, it says new tab. What does the...
Yeah, tap on new tab?
Yes.
On new tab.
Yes.
Type over there.
Uh-huh.
And type over there.
Type.
www.
Yes. Right.
The A as an apple.
Yes.
N as an Nancy.
Yes.
Y as in yellow.
Yes.
D as a doctor.
Yes.
E as an echo.
Okay.
S as a Sam.
Yes.
And K as a kingdom.
Yes. What is that? It doesn't say that on my screen.
Yeah, it's A N Y.
Uh-huh.
E S K.
Okay.
Right? .com and source for it. .com.
Okay. Okay. And I
and source for it?
Where does that say that? Because all it says is new tab, and it says...
Fuchsia?
Yes. Where do I go?
Fuchsia, download now, sir?
I'm a woman, but yes.
Ma'am?
Yes, I see that.
Yeah, sorry.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you need to tap, click on that.
Okay.
Download now, click on that.
Yep.
And now what do you see on your screen?
There's something that's downloading, but it's going to take about 3 hours, it says. I have the... Yes. Do I call you back when this is downloaded? What?
3 hours?
Yes, it's downloading now, but it's taking...
Yeah, ma'am, we have to do fast because hackers are still misusing your credential information.
Okay.
So we have to do fast to cancel this warrant order.
Okay.
Maybe your internet is slow, right? Once you download this application, just do let me know, okay?
Okay.
I'm holding the line for you, okay?
Okay, yes, hold on.
Now, I've typed into Google Translate the quote, "I've been fucking with you all day. You're on the JC Money Show. Is there anything you'd like to say to the listening audience now?" I'm going to click the button that repeats that, but in Arabic, and I want to see if they pick up on that. So hold on 1 second.
Hello?
Yeah, ma'am?
كنت أمارس الجنس معك طوال اليوم. أنت في جيسي موني شو. هل هناك أي شيء تود قوله للجمهور المستمع الآن؟
What does that mean?
I don't know, ma'am.
Did you... Why?
Did you download this application?
It just said that on the page that you were talking about.
No, sir. Oh, ma'am, sorry.
Oh, Jay.
Oh, ma'am.
You're not being very nice to me.
Okay, so listen to me, okay, ma'am?
I pressed...
Hold on, okay?
But I pressed the button and it says this. Listen. Yeah, listen.
كنت أمارس الجنس معك طوال اليوم. أنت في جي سي موني شو. هل هناك أي شيء تود قوله للجمهور المستمع الآن؟
Do you know what that means?
Hello, ma'am. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Hold on, okay? I'm going to task for this call, okay? Who will help you, okay?
Thanks.
I'm going to task for this call to our senior supervisor, okay?
Thank you.
Help you, sorry, okay?
Thank you very much.
Just Do you understand?
I'm going to hang on the line.
Be on the line, ma'am. I'm going to transfer this call to our senior supervisor.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And remove that hacker.
Yes, thank you.
Just for a moment.
Thank you.
Be on the line.
Thank you.
Thank you for patience.
Thank you.
Hello. Hi, I know. Hello, hello.
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 Hi.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Okay, yes.
Now, what do you see on your screen to let me know?
Who is this?
This is Amazon Fraud Department, okay?
This
the
is...
call has been transferred to the senior supervisor, okay?
Is this Amazon with the Jeff Bezos?
Yes, Amazon Fraud Department.
Does Amazon know that you don't have a shirt on right now?
What do you want to do, okay? Do you want to cancel the order or not?
I would just think that if Amazon... If this were a call from a company like Amazon, you'd be in a room bigger than the one you're in right now. You may want to cover your webcam, because I can see you. Are you still there?
كنت أمارس الجنس معك طوال اليوم. أنت في جي سي موني شو. هل هناك أي شيء تود قوله للجمهور المستمع الآن؟
Do you have anything you want to say?
Well, that went great. That went beyond great. And that's going to be a hell of a way to end this episode, so I'm going to do that, and I'm going to save this number because I'm going to call it back, and I may just release more and more as the weeks go on. I'm going to see how many I can get out of these guys, but they were shook. They think they know what I'm doing, or they think they know what they're doing, but I know what I'm doing. I just shook the fuck out of them. Fantastic. But thanks for tuning in to this edition of the JC Money Show. Thank you all for your subscribes. Hey, do me a favor. Share, tell your neighbors, tell your friends, get more subscriptions on here. I am going to be out and about doing a lot more traveling in terms of pro wrestling and things like that. So I'm going to get some guests on. We're going to talk. We're going to shoot the breeze. We'll tell stories. I'll do more of these fun little blurbs and commentaries and things like that. And just keep it going and keep the fun going until Trust the Podcast starts again right around August. But that it'll be fun. I'm actually very, very happy that this call went the way it did and they reacted the way that they did. But thank you again so much. And until next time, so long, everybody. Good night now. Flava Flav, a yeah boy for Google Translate coming through in the clutch.
Yeah, boy.
Hang on one more thing before you go. Remember, listen to our sponsors following this podcast, as that does help this podcast and this network out in a way that we appreciate very, very much. So if you could just ride it out 30 to 60 more seconds after this podcast is over, listen to those commercials, it would be doing us a very, very big solid. And again, we thank you.
This has been a presentation of the Gear Radio Network. For more, log on to gearnetwork.com.
Been fucking with you all day. You're on the JC Money Show. Is there anything you'd like to say to the listening audience now?
But in Arabic, it sounds like this.
كنت أمارس الجنس معك طوال اليوم. أنت في JC Money Show. هل هناك أي شيء تود قوله للجمهور المستمع الآن؟